What's happening, YouTubers? You are watching an exclusive YouTube clip from Jalen and Jacoby, Jalen Anthony Rose. Tonight, the 2021 NBA Draft. Your Pistons have the first pick. Look like Cade Cunningham's gonna walk across the stage and join your Detroit Pistons. But there's a lot of stars that are gonna be drafted tonight. Jalen Suggs, Jalen Green, Evan Mobley, Davion Mitchell. Long list of great prospects tonight. But what advice do you have for these young men as they turn the page and enter a new chapter of their lives?
First off, you're not an amateur anymore. You're an adult. You're a pro. So you can't be thin-skinned. People going to talk about you. People going to criticize you. People going to tweet about you. People going to judge everything you say, judge everything you do. You got to have tough skin. You got to keep it moving. And sometimes your critics are actually right. And we never get too big to acknowledge whether that's the truth or not. The second thing, money is the root of all evil. It's gonna change the dynamics of your family forever. That's my favorite thing about the draft. That's what I love about this so very much, right? The celebration of success and people going from being in the hood or go from being broke to millionaires and attaining generational wealth. In 1994 in June when I got drafted, that changed the dynamics of my family from living in Detroit City to the suburbs. Took the dynamics for the kids going to public school to private school. This really happens, okay, on nights like this. So I would tell them, since money is the root of all evil, I'll give you a math equation. People gonna come into your life for four different reasons: to add, subtract, multiply, or divide. It's up to you to choose wisely. Best of luck, and always keep basketball first. Fall in love with the game again. Be in that gym. Never let somebody outwork you, and all your goals will happen.
So, Jalen, that's great advice for these young men. Their lives are going to change this evening, but I know your history. You didn't follow that advice.
No.
You didn't follow that advice.
No, that's why I'm able to give it.
What was your rookie experience like? Tell me about the house. Tell me about all the people that were living in the house. Tell me about your rookie year in Denver.
So, you go from having friends and family to having staff members. You're a boss now. You're the breadwinner now. You gotta be an adult now. Like, life changes. You know, Jacoby, when all the bills in your name. After tonight, all the bills in your name. And you know what else? All of everybody else's bills in your name too.
Yeah.
Right? They on your tab. And so for me, I had a couple of my friends living with me. They provided value. K9 was the trainer. Riz was the chef. Tez was the manager and like the orchestrator. And I was the athlete. Everybody had their role. And we functioned like a well-oiled machine. You see me in one of those arenas, you saw one of them. But I was still a 21-year-old kid and first millionaire in my family. So,
true,
hey.
True or false, you had a fridge full of 40s.
Fridge full of 40s? My goal was to have a pool, a swimming pool full of 40s. And then as I thought about the dynamics of all of these bottles in a pool, I'm like, that's just dumb, right? So I'll just go get a jumbo freezer
young
and put them in there.
Men, tonight, don't follow Jalen's example.
Nah.
Follow his advice.
Yes.
Congratulations to everyone getting drafted tonight and all the fans whose franchises changed this evening. We'll be back to talk about it every day on ESPN at 2 p.m.
Appreciate the love, Jalen and Jacoby. We get a people!
Bradley Beal. It's being reported by Bleacher Report that he knows he has a decision to make before the draft about whether or not he will officially request a trade. Jalen, it would behoove the franchise if he did so before the draft to help them with that day. Do you think this happens in the next 48 hours?
And shout out to my brother Shears215. Ain't I Chris today? He even allowed me to borrow his glasses. How about this? So if you're Bradley Beal, when you talk to me about him being moved, you know the first thing I think about? I feel bad for Russ. You know, I feel bad for Russ. His last couple of stops, he got a chance to play with KD, and then he ended up leaving. The team traded hard, and ain't nothing he could do about that. Go to Houston, don't really get a chance to play that long again with Harden. Now you get to Washington. Y'all show some promise late in the season, and Bradley Beal may potentially ask for a trade. But here's what I want to make sure I acknowledge for you, David.
What's up?
This is actually a good thing for Russ, because if Bradley Beal requests a trade, that means they talked about it. And if they talked about it, that means Washington can look up, and once training camp starts, there's a good chance that they have a new roster. Is Bradley Beal and Russell Westbrook at this point of their careers the future of the Washington Wizards? I ask you, is that the future? Since it's not, you got to go ahead and start laying them dominoes right now if you're their general manager, Tommy Shepherd, because both of those guys' value is as high as it's going to get. And you got to sell high in this case.
And there's so many duos in the league. And Jalen, what do I always say about duos? You've heard this a million times. I like my duos to be complementary. While Beal and Westbrook are both great contributors, they're not complementary players to each other. Something tells me they will not be a duo on the Wizards moving forward. But who will get moved? We will see. The question now in the air is, will Kawhi Leonard return to the Clippers? Friend of the show, Mark Stein, reported that it's not necessarily a guarantee that he'll be back. And maybe the Heat or the Knicks or some other teams, the Mavs, would show interest. And our guy Woj, your Countdown crew brother, said that he's not sold on that. He sees Kawhi with the Clippers. Nostradamus, where do you see Kawhi next year?
As a member of the Clippers, because these all-time great players, Jacoby, you know what they don't want to do? Be like me and bounce all around the NBA if they don't have to. So Kawhi goes to Toronto after leaving San Antonio and wins the championship. Now he picks his destination. He's at where he's at. He be where he want to be. And you know what you don't want to do this offseason? Be bouncing around taking team meetings on crutches because you just had surgery. You stay with the Clippers, you get as much money as possible, and they already have established a relationship that you're not going to miss, that you're going to miss games due to low management. See, what happens now, you go somewhere else, they're like, well, I guess you could play 75 games. You know, why don't you try it? But in this situation, the Clippers have already basically built the equity with Kawhi Leonard, and he's probably going to play 65 games a year. Paul George ascended, and his confidence grown after this playoff run, so he's shown that he can hold it down when Kawhi's not going to be there. And this for the Clippers, to me, as they move into a new arena, you want to have Kawhi Leonard in uniform. I believe he'll be there.
I think he'll be there as well. I mean, this isn't the Kawhi Leonard free agents that we saw after his championship finals MVP in Toronto. He was healthy. He was the king of the court. He was the mountaintop. He just had the finals MVP. After the bubble collapse and after this year, after knowing that he won't even be able to take the floor until probably after the All-Star break, I don't know if that is a player that wants to be in the market or a player that teams are necessarily want to bring into their franchise at the price tag that he's going to demand. Jalen Anthony Rose, you're never going to believe this. You're never going to believe this. There are reports about a star player going to the Los Angeles Lakers. I know that's hard for you to wrap your head around, but the latest is that the Spurs free agent DeMar DeRozan would take less money to come to the Lakers. Now, keep in mind, he was making a lot of money, and the Lakers could offer him the $9.5 million. Something tells me when he talks about getting a haircut, he's talking about a sign and trade, not necessarily signing for $9.5 million a year.
You never get what you deserve in business, only what you have the leverage to negotiate. And what this sounds like here is a seasoned veteran player who's a perennial 20-plus point scorer understands if he's going to be on a contender, he's not going to make the kind of bread that he made in San Antonio. In theory, the thing that broke he and Kyle Lowry up from Toronto is they both needed to get their money. And so since he went to San Antonio and got his bread, Kyle Lowry stayed in Toronto and got his bread. Those are going to be two of the 500 players that the national media put on the Lakers this offseason.
We're running out of Photoshop. We have so many players in the Lakers so far. Lowry, DeRozan, Westbrook, Beal,
CP3.
CP3, Dame. We have so many players on the Lakers.
There are some whispers. There are some rumors from Bleacher Report that Ben Simmons and the Sixers are not seeing eye to eye this offseason, so much so that they haven't really been communicating like they normally do during the offseason. Obviously, Simmons was offered in a trade for James Harden. And then once the Sixers season was over, there are a lot of rumors about him leaving town. Jalen, what does this tell you about the Simmons-Sixers relationship?
Basic professional etiquette 101. if your job or your boss reaches out to you that happens to be paying you millions of dollars, you should return the call. Just normal protocol. But in all honesty, I feel like this relationship is gonna end with Ben Simmons ultimately being traded. I think that's why he's not necessarily returning their calls, because he knows that they're shopping him. And the one thing about getting traded, and you know I can relate because I've been moved multiple times, is sometimes you see it coming, and then also before it happens, people assassinate your character. Then they say things like this that people don't know if they're true or not. So the fans that you do have are not upset that you got moved. It's a weird mental gymnastic that happens in professional sports. But with that being said, the way he performed in the playoffs, in their final series, and particularly his lack of productivity in the fourth quarter, you can't have him and Joel Embiid being your two best players and feel like that you're going to contend for a championship. When they're at their best, they occupy the same space on the floor, the colored area.
I really think that if he were to be traded to another team, it would be mutually beneficial for both franchises. I'm big on Ben Simmons, and I would definitely be in the market for him were I a GM around the league. I think he's extremely productive. He is the second vote-getter in Defensive Player of the Year, the second best defender in the entire league, a great passer, has great vision, and without Joel Embiid on the floor, there's another team, another chemistry, another offense for him in which he will be very successful. And I also understand maybe he doesn't want to talk. They literally offered him in a trade already. Once the buzzer was over in the Hawks series, they put him on 17 different teams in the media. I understand why he feels a certain way, and I hope that for him Jacob, and the Sixers, that this ends up in a fair trade for both teams.
Everything you say is A-plus spot on, my brother, and I want to add to that. The Philadelphia 76ers, in theory, are the only team that have an anchor post player like Joel Embiid that requires them to run their offense that way. If you look around the league, the floor is normally spread. And a guy like Ben Simmons now, who embodies positionless basketball, is able to take advantage of his athleticism, his quickness, his speed, and his ability to finish. But if you have Joel Embiid, of course you need to feature him. And so that's the dilemma that they have. He's their franchise player. Ben is going to end up somewhere else. And I, like you, know that he's going to ball when he gets to his next destination. He's going to do work at his next destination. So everybody that get a chance to assassinate his character and talking about how he's spending his offseason and talking about how much a house that he's hanging out in California costs, all of that is irrelevant. When the season start and or when Ben Simmons get traded, trust me, he's going to go somewhere else and do work and still be an all-star level player.